Thank you. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Laurence died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. My brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for our brother Laurence, that he may share in Christ's victory. And let us pray for ourselves, that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. And now we'll have the eulogy. Please be seated.
This day would come, yet it still feels too soon. My grandfather lived a good life, dedicated to those he loved and held dear. Though his last decade with us was marked by trying times, his strength and resilience persisted. His selfless resolve never faded, and he could still find humor in any situation. No words could possibly express how grateful my family and I are for having been a part of his life's journey. Born in Sangre Grande on the 5th day of September in 1936, Laurence Emile was the second son of four children of the parents, Doris Emile and Andrew Lee. Throughout his life, he was known to many as Chiny, Harold, or Emil, but at home, he was always Daddy. A true son of Sangre Grande soil, He set his roots in Providence in the early 1950s with my darling grandmother Anna. And their six sons and daughter. As a young couple, they built a life, developed friendships and relationships with their neighbors that lasted through many years and milestones. Daddy had a long career in government service until his retirement in 1997. I still have fond memories of spending summers with him in Tunapuna near the end of his career, where he would come home for lunch and to watch The Young and the Restless, one of his guilty pleasures. He would happily regale to his grandchildren and to anyone who would listen stories of his time at Takarigua, Mount Hope, and the other medical services he was a part of. He maintained his passion for his tailoring craft that he had developed in his youth and for music. He truly loved his music. He was one of the lead musicians at the St. Charles RC Church in Tunapuna, and one of the founding members and lead guitarist of the Los Numeros Parang Band. Members of which he called his friends, and who all of us called aunties and uncles for as long as I can remember. Between the months of September and January, his social calendar would be filled with events, parties, competitions, a guaranteed jovial time. But the real fun was always the practice sessions held at each other's homes.
Yeah, man.
He always looked forward to blagging with the boys, as he would say. The highlight of the year would always be his wedding anniversary party, hosted by him and his beautiful wife, Andrea. And closing out the season, celebrating his firstborn grandson's birthday on Lewa, January 6th. Daddy was an exemplar of family love. He loved his children, and later the following generations. I would even boast that his influence was greatest on my cousin Candace and I, as we were blessed with the opportunity to have grown up with him at home, and to have his undivided attention. I'm sure each one of us can remember a time we caught him mysteriously staring at us and taking a second trying to figure out whether or not we were in trouble or if he was just admiring his beautiful grandchild. Ironically, the deadpan facial expression was always the same in either situation. And if in fact we were in trouble at that point, good luck escaping his reach. There was no denying that he loved his children, but he had a very special bond and a very special place in his heart for his girls. He was the ultimate girl dad. He and my mom could talk for days if given the opportunity. He always looked forward to phone calls from mom where they would spend hours chatting about anything. Or when mom visited, they could easily spend hours chatting and catching up. We all witnessed his tough persona soften the day his baby girl Allison brought home her baby girl. For weeks after Candace first came home, when he believed everyone was asleep, he would quietly sneak out of his room, checking on Allison and Candace, convinced that it was his little secret. Candace captured his heart very early on. They shared a very special bond as she grew up. They would always play and nap together. He lit up when she started talking with the sweetest little lisp and called him Papa. He made sure to teach us lessons that he learned throughout his life. He was always available to help us navigate through our own struggles. He was a confidant to us all. Always ready to listen and give counsel. Though set in his ways, he was very liberal and always willing to hear both sides of an argument and never judged. He taught us that happiness could be found in the simple things in life. His simple things were the Guardian newspaper, morning radio talk shows on Power 102 FM, music practice, and quality times with the ones he loved. Daddy, Papa, thank you for showing us. Thank you for showing up for us all when we needed you. Thank you for teaching us to live a life without compromise. Thank you for showing us to walk in humility and what love is truly about. I know Grandfather was not only an inspiration to me, but to so many. So today I'm sure he would not want us to leave here mourning, but rejoicing, for he lived a good life, a great life.
Let us pray. Please stand. O God, in whom sinners find mercy and the saints find joy, we pray to you for our brother Laurence, whose body we honor with a Christian burial, that he may be delivered from the bonds of death. Admit him to the joyful company of your saints and raise him up on the last day to rejoice in your presence forever. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth. In the Lord, for the Lord has said so. This day it will be said, see, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd. He is Lord and I his guest. Fresh and green are the pastures where he leads me to.
Alle, alle, alle. Alleluia. Alle, alle, alle.
Please stand. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "See that you are dressed for action and have your lamps lit. Be like men waiting for your master to return from the wedding feast, ready to open the door as soon as he comes and knocks. Happy those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. I tell you solemnly, he will put on an apron, sit them down at table, and wait on them. It may be in the second watch he comes, or in the third, but happy those servants if he find them ready. You may be quite sure of this, that if the householder had known at what hour the burglar would come, he would not have let anyone break through the wall of his house. You too must stand ready, because the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated for a short reflection. And I will use this opportunity on behalf of the parish to render my condolences to the family and all those who are gathered here for the loss of Laurence. And we thank God for his life, for the eulogy, and I can see he has left a rich legacy. As I look at the special jerseys being worn, you know, so I think he definitely has done his part, and God chose to call him home. But we who are here, we are still on the journey. And God is saying to us today, we have to be ready. We cannot allow death to take us by chance, because death is the pathway to eternal life. The eternal life that was won on the cross of Calvary for all of us. So we have to spend this time preparing so that we will have that entry into heaven. Jesus did not die in vain. He died out of love for us, just as he created us out of love for us. And he has put everything in place so that we could enter into heaven. It is up to us to make the right choices. You know, the world tells us certain things. Our flesh tells us certain things. The devil tells us many things. But God's word tells us the truth. And we have to pay attention to his word. Deuteronomy 28 tells us, obedience to God brings blessings, and disobedience brings curses. So we are always caught with a choice. We have to pray, we have to receive the sacraments that God, the church, has established so that we could be strengthened. And so we'll be able to make the right choices and be ready. For when God calls us, it is not a surprise, but it is the time that we have been preparing for our whole life. And so, from every death, we should get more and more prepared, more and more ready for when God calls each and every one of us home.
because death is sure. Where we are going is up to us and our choices. So we think we have a lot of time because we are young, but many have been called at a young age. Many are called middle age, many are called older. We do not know the hour. So let us be ready. Let us not get caught up with the world and the things that it has to offer. But let us always seek God in everything, every choice we make. And so we'll be assured of that place in heaven that Jesus prepared for us, each and every one of us. And he wants us to have a good life, abundant life. Don't believe that he doesn't want us to have a good life. Our choices will be in keeping with that good life. And when we disobey, then that is where the trouble comes. So let us be sure that God wants what's best for us. And let us make the choices that he wants us to make. Amen? Is there something that's going to be rendered now? I saw on the program.
During the collection?
If not, I will go on to the intercessions.
Okay, we now have a collection for the church. The intercessions.
Go ahead with the intercessions?
Yes, dear. Yeah.
Okay. Please stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Laurence, strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the family and friends of Laurence, seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Together, let's say that Our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil.
and grant us peace in our days. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Would there be any collection? Did you all have any special?
There's a collection for the church. A collection will be taken up now for the church.
Yes, there's a collection at this point for the church. Thank you.
Okay, so we'll be seated for the collection.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the safety first shall end up on the shore,
as we gather to commend our brother Laurence to God our Father and to commit his body to the earth, let us express our common faith in the resurrection. As Jesus Christ was raised from the dead, we too are called to follow him through death to the glory where God will be all in all.
Into your hands we command your spirit, O Lord. Into your hands we command your heart, all we have done to us and to love you. Into your hands we command our love. I will
the soul of Laurence, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We gather here to commend our brother to God our Father and to commit his body to the earth. In the spirit of faith in the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, let us offer our prayers for Laurence. Because God has chosen to call our brother Laurence from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return.
And I will raise him up, and I will raise him up, and I will raise him up on the
right.
the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother Laurence to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise him up and raise up his body on the last day. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And let perpetual life shine upon him.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Service is over. Final song. Final song.
I'm walking on my way to the Lord, to my Lord, 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 to my Lord's house. I'm walking on my way to the Lord, to my Lord, who's waiting there for me. So let's all join hands and praise the Lord. Yes, love our Lord, 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 to our Lord's house. So let's join hands and praise the Lord.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. And all my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna say. didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah.
I have already Many questions unanswered.